Top 10 awesome games you can get for less than 10 euros. Gaming can be expensive sometimes. Newly released games can cost an arm and a leg, and it takes ages for their prices to drop to an affordable level. But you don't necessarily have to sell your kidney to be able to scratch your gaming itch. Welcome to our list of top 10 awesome games you can get for less than 10 euros on G2A.com. Today, we're going to introduce you to some truly amazing titles that are way cheaper than you would think. If you'd like to grab any of the games from the list, make sure to visit our under 10 euros sale by clicking the link in the description. And make sure to subscribe to our channel for more gaming top 10 lists. Let's dive into the list. Number 10, Superhot. Superhot is an experimental indie FPS with a fun little gameplay gimmick that changes everything. You see, the time in the game only moves when you move. This means that the enemies and their bullets move in slow motion as long as you don't do anything, allowing you to anticipate their actions, dodge incoming blows, and grab their weapons from their hands before they even notice you're next to them. Basically, the game allows you to play as Neo from The Matrix. The minimalistic, simple graphic style makes the game very visually distinctive, and breaking your opponents into tiny pieces can be very satisfying. Seriously though, viewers, you have to play this game. It's the most innovative shooter we've played in years. Number 9. Borderlands, the pre-sequel. Taking place between the first and second installments of Borderlands, the pre-sequel takes you to the moon, where you witness the rise to power of the series' iconic villain, Handsome Jack, from the perspective of his lackeys. As in the previous Borderlands games, you can choose from four playable characters with various abilities and playstyles. Of course, the most important feature of the game is its huge variety of randomly generated guns, and shooting your enemies in their faces with them. The gravity on the moon is much lower than on Pandora, which allows you to take advantage of incredibly high jumps, but you will also have to watch out for your oxygen level. All in all, the pre-sequel is a must-have for all Borderlands fans, as well as other gamers who enjoy FPS. Number 8. Battlefield 4. Battlefield 4 is an excellent choice for multiplayer FPS enthusiasts who enjoy large-scale objective-based combat with a focus on teamwork and strategy. The game offers a remarkable amount of weapons and gadgets, and the players can use a variety of air and land vehicles as well as boats in combat. The huge maps are both dynamic and interactive, allowing for some spectacular moments via the Levolution system. The game also includes a solid single-player campaign, though it must be noted that the excellent multiplayer mode is the main focus of Battlefield 4. Number 7. Call of Duty – Black Ops. Black Ops is a classic and beloved entry in the franchise, and it offers the full Call of Duty experience, with an amazing multiplayer mode and a memorable single-player campaign. Set in the 1960s during the Cold War, the story mode follows Alex Mason, an elite CIA agent on a series of secret missions carried out behind enemy lines. The plot is truly remarkable, with many shocking plot twists, making this one of the best-written single-player campaigns in the history of the franchise. Like in any Call of Duty title, the multiplayer is the meat of Black Ops. The gameplay is focused on fast-paced, small-scale infantry combat, with the players controlling elite Spec Ops soldiers. The ability to customize your weapons and character is immense, and the individual skill of the player comes into play, especially with the killstreak mechanic, allowing the player to deploy special attacks as a reward for successfully getting rid of many enemies in a row without dying. Despite the game's age, it still boasts a large user base, making the multiplayer very much alive in 2018. Number 6. Cities: Skylines. Cities: Skylines is considered by many fans of the genre the most in-depth modern city-building simulator, and the best thing that happened to the city management genre since the days of classic SimCity games. Predictably, it includes features such as designing your settlement, keeping your citizens happy, and expanding your city's territory and population. It might sound simple, but in reality, City Skylines has you taking care of multiple aspects of city management, including transit, electricity, public health and schooling system, and more, making this game an incredibly complex, multi-layered, and challenging simulation. It doesn't make it unapproachable to complete beginners though. The game has a nice learning curve, making it easy to play, but quite difficult to master. In any case, the replay value is immense, and keeping a watch next to the computer is a must, unless you want to be surprised by the dawn after playing the whole night. Number 5. Rocket League. Have you ever wondered what it would be like to play football with a car? Probably not, because why would you ever think of that? Turns out that it would be extremely fun, though. Silly as it may sound, Rocket League is an extremely fun and addictive game that will keep you entertained for long hours. Whether you're a complete rookie or a flying car scoring goals virtuoso, the game is also great to enjoy with your friends, since it supports up to 4-player split screen and cross-platform connectivity. Number 4. Fallout New Vegas. Fallout New Vegas is amongst the most beloved positions of the entire post-apocalyptic franchise. It offers a vast, open world, and a freedom to explore it in any way you want. Each quest and conflict can be solved in a variety of different ways, and you can choose the type of playstyle that suits you the best. It's viable to roam the post-apocalyptic wasteland as a complete pacifist who refuses to take any lives, or to become a trigger-happy cannibal who consumes their enemies' corpses to regenerate health. Or anything between those two extremes. Of course, the reputation system means that there will be consequences for your choices. The storyline of the game is incredibly complex, and the characters and factions you come across are diverse and well fleshed out. Depending on your choices, you can either join one of the factions or be the wild card with your own ways of bringing order to the wasteland. And as a result, you can experience multiple completely different endings, giving the game great replay value. Number 3. Darkest Dungeon. If you love the feeling of being certain that the game is cheating, even though you know it's not, and rage quitting after a whole team of heroes you've been nurturing and leveling up gets wiped before you even get close to the boss fight, then this turn-based, Lovecraft-inspired roguelike might be the right pick for you. In all seriousness, the Darkest Dungeon is wonderfully complex and unforgiving, punishing you mercilessly for any mistake, including getting overconfident in an easy fight and drawing it out for too long to heal up your squad. The game includes some interesting gameplay quirks, including mental health metric, which is just as important as the HP meter, as well as various afflictions which will impair your 6th level heroes to the point of uselessness unless you use your precious time and money to heal them. Quite fast you will learn that everyone is expendable, and naming your heroes after your friends is a bad idea. Number 2. Far Cry 3. One of the most acclaimed games of the established FPS series, Far Cry 3 tells the story of an unfortunate tourist who accidentally gets involved with a slave-trading pirate gang on a remote tropical island. As the main character, Jason, tries to save his friends and loved ones from the clutches of Vas Montenegro and his gang, he gradually changes from a mostly innocent man, unsure how to handle a gun, into a ruthless killer hell-bent on revenge. This evolution is not ignored by the game, and the gratuitous violence exhibited by the player-controlled character has consequences on his relationships with others, as well as on his own mental health. The game offers a huge open world, with beautiful scenery and an interactive setting full of things to do and enemies to shoot. The actors' performances are also a great boon, making the characters believable and relatable, with the volatile Vas taking the prize for one of the most memorable villains in gaming. Number 1. Portal 2. Portal 2 picks up where the original Valve hit left off, and expands the amazing gameplay ideas from the first Portal wonderfully. Story-wise, we get to know the sociopathic villain, GLaDOS, and her backstory, which turns out to be surprisingly sad, as well as the history of Aperture Science. Mechanic-wise, while portals still stay at the core of gameplay, new gadgets and gimmicks are added to our arsenal, making the game anything but repetitive compared to its predecessor. The game also adds a co-op mode, where players take on the role of two bumbling robots helping GLaDOS further her scientific goals. All in all, Portal 2 is a great sequel of the first Portal, and an excellent logic game with a great sense of humor that can be played separately from the previous game of the series. So, that's it for our list. Don't forget, if any of the games caught your attention, click the link in the description to grab them for less than 10 euros. Make sure to let us know in the comments if we inspired you to check any of them out, and see you next time.